guys, long time no see. I'm back, and please excuse the background. It's messy, I know, but I think this is the best place to film because there are like all of this, like from this side in front of me and all the way to the there. It's our window. It's the best lights I can get in my house, and it's actually storage and boiler room, so you're gonna hear some noise. And yeah, it's different, it's something new, but I'm gonna go with that. Okay, so I'm gonna film get ready with me video because it's been a while since I filmed my last one. So yeah, let's go ahead. I have finished prepping my face. I put on moisturizer, sunscreen, primer, and fix mist to set everything in the place. So I am gonna go with putting some foundation. So I'm gonna try this one. This is by Aritaun Full Color Foundation in number one light beige. It's a super lightweight foundation, perfect for summer. And I don't know if you can see, but I have like really enlarged pores. So I think this is gonna be good. But since this is light beige, which is too light for me, for my complexion, so I'm gonna add this Maybelline's Birthday Better Skin foundation because it's a bit darker than my skin tone, I think. So I'm gonna mix these two to make a perfect shade for my face. So it doesn't, see, it's runny, and like you can see, it's really runny and light. So I'm gonna mix a little bit of this. You can see the color difference. I'm gonna mix this too and apply. Oh, I think it's still light for my skin, but I'm gonna go with that. As you can see, I have so many like blemishes, scars, and just redness, and it's a mess. It's a mess. And yeah, let's just blend this out. And I'm using a beauty sponge from Daiso. This isn't the original beauty blender. I guess you can tell by the color of this. I don't know if you guys can tell or not, but I have had a haircut. It was originally like way shorter than this length, but it's been a while, almost a month or two. I don't quite remember exactly when I got it, but it's been a while, so my hair has grown much longer. I don't know why I have so many redness. Yep, that's what I'm doing now. I feel like someone's watching me. I think the coverage is, it says it's a full cover, but I think it's medium, like a buildable medium coverage. But I prefer that way than just like a full cover out of just one like application. I like lightweight foundation. So like I like to have control over the coverage because if it's like just full cover out of just one application, it is so easy to be cakey face. So yeah, that's that. And I still see some like some places that needs more improvement. Like here and here, and my face is just so messy. So I'm gonna use the same line, add it down for a cover in this is concealer, and the color is again number one light beige. This is really heavy duty, like thick concealer, so I'm gonna use I'm gonna use this little by little because it's such a, you know, like a heavy duty concealer. So let's put it a little bit under my eyes too. And I want you, like, I want to update you guys on my, like, getting a job journey with me, like, my journey. So, I have been applying a lot lately, and I had some interviews at some global companies like Unilever. You know, the company that makes Dove and Magnum and all that brands. It's a huge company, and I had interview. The job title was marketing assistant, and I didn't get it. It's hard, you know, it's hard getting a full-time job at a global company. It takes time and effort, so I was a little bit disappointed, but well, what am I gonna do? Keep trying. What else? I'm not gonna quit, you know. So yeah. And I also applied for some major company, and I'm hoping to get it. I'm really hoping to get it. Wish me luck, guys. I cannot wait to start working. So, I still have some redness. I don't know why, but see, I know why, because I was just on my period. So that is why my skin has broken up like crazy. I need more coverage. I don't know if I'm in the shot or not. Oops. So yeah, I hope, you know, again, I hope this messy, untamed, unorganized background doesn't annoy you that much. I hope. But I think the lighting is, I mean, it's not a sunny day today. It's super gloomy outside because it's monsoon season in Korea. So, I it's gloomy and cloudy, but I hope you guys can see what I'm doing better, because in my room, like my pretty much all of my previous videos was filmed in my room, which has like such a poor natural light. It doesn't have natural light pretty much like at all, so I hope this comes out like better than that. So yeah, I'm just gonna stop here because I don't think like these will be like camouflaged like perfectly, so I'm just gonna stop here. It is what it is, and I'm gonna set this with a powder. This is Innisfree No Sebum Mineral powder pack, and this is almost basically empty. I love this, especially during the summer, like since I have bangs. And during the summer, like this T-zone, my forehead and my nose gets super oily really quickly. So I need to set like this T-zone area really well, because if my forehead gets oily, that means my bangs, because it's right, it's covering my forehead, right? So if my forehead gets oily, that means my bangs gets oily, and that doesn't look cute at all. So I'm gonna set, and oh, and so this is Esther Anti-Shine Matitude powder, and it's almost empty too. So yeah, set that. And let's move on to setting the under eyes. I'm using the Rare Techniques setting brush, I think. Yeah, it's a setting brush. I'm just gonna put this in this spray. And then I'm gonna coat again with this Esther powder packed. Again. So yeah, I am planning to film like few more videos today, but I don't know how that will turn out, because it might rain in any minute from now. So that's that. And I'm gonna fix my eyebrow. This is the old Skin Food Choco Eyebrow Powder Cake. It's almost empty. So I tamed my brows not that long ago, and I did it by myself, and I really like how this brow turned out. But not so much on this one, because I was trying to, because I tamed it this side first, so I was trying to make this as similar as this one, and it didn't turn out that well. I think it's way too like thin and narrow. So yep. And I'm pretty sure you guys have like heard of the well-known, like a popular, like a straight brows in Korea. Like how straight brows are like a popular thing in Korea beauty community, and that has changed recently. So the new trends, the eyebrow trends in Korea is more arch style, not so much of just straight brows. So Yeah. That's enough for brows, I think. I don't really like pay like that much attention to my brows because I have bangs and it's always covered under my bangs, so I don't care that much. That's that, and I'm gonna go. Let me see. Hope it's filming. Let me check. Yeah, it's filming. So let's go with the onto the eyes. This is actually a tin case that I had, and I departed all the single shadows. So I'm glad, I'm so glad I did that, because it's so much convenient. And oops, it has moved, but this is another case. So let's see. I think I'm gonna use these two shadows, the most used ones. These are by Mary Kay. Just gonna put this as a base. I'm gonna mix these two and gently apply them. Apply the shadows. I don't know what I'm what kind of look that I'm going for today. I just decided, you know, like I want to film, and I got shower and put on moisturizer and all that, and I made my coffee, and I was gonna film right away. Then I got a mail from Headhunter asked me to send her a English version of cover letter, because I only sent her Korean version, and she said, well, this company only accept English version. So I think I'm gonna go for more like a curly look. So I'm gonna mix this too. I'm gonna mix and gently apply that. So yeah, so I did that, and I sent her the cover letter, and she hasn't checked it out yet. So I hope she, you know, sees it and get me an interview soon. Guys, wish me luck on this. It's a really, really a huge company that I'm dying to work for. It's not like a permanent job. It's temporary, like 6 month contract job. But I don't care. I'm dying to get the job. So yeah, I'm gonna do that, and I'm gonna slightly use this Kiko shadow and tap the excess off, because it is pigmented. So just slightly put on the color to my crease. So yeah, let's go ahead, do the same thing again. Oops. And then I'm gonna blend this together. It's just a kabuki brush. I'm gonna blend this too. Yep. And then I'm gonna put this is all the writings all like rubbed off, but this is by a Pew shadow stick in CR1. So I'm gonna just put this right here, the corners of my eyes, or under and at the corners. And then I'm gonna curl my lashes. And I'm gonna use this waterproof eyeliner by Aritown. Color is gold on khaki. Just go slightly. Oops, I forgot my Q-tips. Oops. Because I like to smudge the liners with Q-tips, but since I don't have that, I think I'm gonna go with the brush to do that. Oh no, I don't think that was a good idea. Oh no! This side is alright, I think. It's okay, it's not bad, but this side is okay. It's too much. Still too much. I'm gonna set this. More. I'm using the powder. So yep. It is what it is. So yep, that's that. And I'm gonna use a mascara. I use like this combination a lot lately. This is by Essence Get Big Lashes, and I coat my lashes with this first, and then I coat with this one, Maybelline Rocket, on top of that. So I think that's enough, and then this is Rocket by Maybelline. Oops, teeny tiny bit. So next. Oops, I got it on my lid. That happens all the time. And again with the Rocket, I'm gonna coat again. Oh my god, I have so much stuff on my eyelid. I don't even know why. I don't even know what's going on here. So that's so my dog is finally. She finally found me. looking, and she finally found me, and she's crying for me to like get out of this room and play with her. So yeah, I'll be back. So I got her. I hope she's gonna be like sitting on my laps for next, I don't know, like 3 or 5 minutes. So eyes are done and I'm gonna go with blush. And lately I've been loving this Bridia. It's a really pretty lilac, like Bridia Festival Blush 301 sugar violet. So I'm gonna put this all over my face. Because it's such a light color, I don't mind like packing this on. And then let's blend this up a little bit more. I like how it like brightens my complexion. It was rather a dull, jewel-like my complexion, but this lilac blush really brightens my face, I think. So that is that, and I'm gonna, here, this is my lip pouch. I got this from a thrift store in Vancouver quite a long time ago, pretty much 6 years ago. So I think I'm gonna go with this shade. This is Estee Lauder Pure Color MB Lipstick 330 Impassioned. That's such a pretty color. So I'm gonna put this on. I don't like full application. I just like slightly dab and then gradational. What's the word? Gradation? I think it's gradation. So yeah, maybe I need more, just so slightly more. So yeah, this is my finished look, and I'm gonna fix my hair and then I'm gonna come back. This is my finished look. I just curled my hair just a little bit and let my bangs down. Yeah, but it's a mess because it's been so long since I let my bangs down. So please excuse the messiness, but yep, this is a finished look. Yeah, I'm gonna come to you with another video soon. Thank you for watching. Bye.